happy, woke him up one midnight. He said, "Before the sheriff comes, I want to tell you, listen, boy." Said, "Learn to ball a jack, learn to lay a track, learn to pick and shovel too, and take my hammer. It'll do anything you tell it to." John Henry's mammy had about a dozen babies. John Henry's pappy broke jail about a dozen times. The babies all got sick, and when the doctor wanted money, he said, "I'll pay you a quarter at a time. Start tomorrow. That's a pay for a steel driver on his line." Then the section foreman said, "Hey, hammer swinger, I see you brought your own hammer, boy, but what else can all them muscles do?" And he said, "I can turn a jack, I can lay a track, I can pick and shovel too.
Can you swing a hammer, boy?"
"Yes, sir, I'll do anything you hire me to."
"Now, ain't you something so high and mighty with your muscles? Just go ahead, boy, and pick up that hammer. Pick up the hammer."
He said, "Get a rusty spike and swing it down three times. I'll pay you a nickel a day for every inch you sink into. Go on and do what you say you can do." With a steep-nosed hammer on a four-foot switch handle, John Henry raised it back till it touched his heels. And the spike went through the cross tie and it split it half in two. 35 cents pay for driving steel.
"Sweat, sweat, boy, sweat. You owe me two more swings.
I was born for driving steel." Well, John Henry hammered in the mountain. He'd give a grunt and he'd give a groan with every swing. The women folks for miles around heard him and come down to watch him make the cold steel ring. Lord, what a swinger! Just listen to that cold steel ring. But the bad boss come up laughing at John Henry. Said, "You full of vinegar now, but you bout through. We gonna get a steam drill to do your share driving. What's all them muscles gonna do, huh, John Henry? Gonna take a little bit of vinegar out of you." John Henry said, "I feed four little brothers and baby sisters walking on her knees. Did the Lord say that machines ought to take the place of living? And what's a substitute for bread and beans? I ain't seen it. Do engines get rewarded for their steam?" John Henry hid in a coal mine for his dinner nap. Had 30 minutes to rest before the bell. The mine boss hollered, "Get up, whoever you are, and get a pickaxe. Give me enough coal to start another hill and keep it burning. Mind me enough to start another hill." John Henry said to his captain, "A man ain't nothing but a man. But if you bring that steam drill around, I'll beat it fair and honest. I'll die with my hammer in my hand, but I'll be laughing. 'Cause you can't replace a steel driving man." There was a big crowd of people at the mountain. John Henry said to the steam drill, "How is you?" "Pardon me, Mr. Steam Drill, I suppose you didn't hear me." "I said, how you? Huh? Well, can you turn a jack? Can you lay a track? Can you pick and shovel too? Listen to Hammer Swinger's talking to you."
Shh.
somebody hollered,
"The mountain's caving in!"
John Henry told the captain, "Tell the kind folks don't to worry. It ain't nothing but my hammer sucking wind that keeps me breathing. This steel driver's muscle, I ain't tin." Captain, tell the people move back further. I'm at the finish line and there ain't no drill. It's so far behind, but yet ain't got the brains to quit it. When she blows up, she'll scatter across the hills, Lord, Lord. When she blows up, she'll scatter across the hills. Well, John Henry had a little woman. I believe the lady's name was Polly Ann. Yeah, that was his good woman. John Henry threw his hammer over his shoulder and went on home. He lay down to rest his weary back, and early next morning he said, "Come here, Polly Ann. Come here, sugar. You know, I believe this is the first time I ever watched the sun come up that I couldn't come up. Take my hammer, Polly Ann, and go to that railroad. Swing that hammer like you seen me do it. And when you're swinging with a lead man, they'll all know. They'll all know you're John Henry's woman, but tell them that ain't all you can do. Tell them, I can hoist a jack and I can lay a track. I can pick and shovel too. Ain't no machine can. That's been proved to you."
Från Norge var det jag till banen kom. Fråga icke, jag vill ej berätta om varför jag drog över gränsen upp till banen långt i nord. Kanske har jag själv glömt varför jag for. Men ifrån den dagen då jag la i väg fulgte jag den banen mödigt steg för steg. Det var sol och varme dagar, men i vinterns is och snö var det blåsligt köll och skort på dagligt bröd. Det var sjukdom, och när du kom inomhus var det jäkligt där, i halmen var det lus. Ingen läkare på platsen när ett mineskott gick fel. Ingen präst tog hand om sluskens arme skel. Jag var icke enda rallarflickan alls. Flickor kom och hit till banen tiotals. Det var Lappelisa, Lusedora och hon Tromf Karin, och hon Silverbruden och hon Tjock Elin. Och hon Björne Maja minnes jag så väl. I ett slagsmål slog den flickan mig ihjäl. Ifrån Rombaksfjällen flög min fria själ till himlens borg. Och på brättet står det skrivet Anna Norr. Nu är jag i himlen och från någon sky kan jag titta ner på festivalens by. Men hör ni borgare i detta undan gömta småstadshörn, ni får icke lov att håna svarta björn. Ibland rallare och slusk tog jag min törn. Fjällets gossar kallte mig för svarta björn. Detta namn som jag dog med var ett hjältehedersnamn, känd från Kiruna och till Victoriahamn. Jag var våldsam, jag var kär och jag var stark. var jag gick där såg jag mina händers verk. På min vandring genom livet gick jag ut för många stup. Men jag sjönk ej ner till någon slags pinup.